Picture this. Two young Kenyan school dropouts with no fancy degrees, no tech labs, just scraps and a dream. Decide to challenge the very limits of human innovation. Afrogenesis, a biorobotic arm controlled entirely by brain signals. Yes, brain signals. So how did they do it? How did they go from textbooks they probably didn't finish to building tech that looks like it belongs in a sci-fi thriller?
One can also switch on and off lights in a room.
By just thinking, you can't change the TV station.
Forget Neuralink and billion-dollar budgets. This is grassroots brilliance, hand-forged in the fires of ambition and sheer determination.
They tell us that with this technology, a person with no arms can drive a car.
These droppers didn't just think outside the box. They rewired the box to move on command. Afrogenesis isn't just an invention. It's a reality check to anyone who has ever doubted African ingenuity. It's the kind of tech that makes you wonder, how on earth did they pull this off? Well, spoiler alert. They didn't have labs, grants, or billion-dollar investors. Instead, they had creativity, scraps, and a helmet that looks like something straight out of a dystopian fashion show. The magic starts with the helmet, the neural node of the operation. Instead of a sleek sci-fi chip implanted into your brain, this is a full-blown headpiece packed with electrodes. You slap it on your head, and voila, it starts reading your brain signals.
Welcome to Afrogenesis, Systems Online, Bio-Robotics, Neural Prosthesis. Afrogenesis, where we are interfacing man with machine.
It's like the love child of a lie detector and a construction helmet, but somehow it works.
Analyzing data.
Welcome to Afrogenesis, Systems Online, Bio-Robotics, Neural Prosthesis.
My name is David Gathujeri. I co-founded this structured scientific organization together with my partner Moses Kuna, the biorobotic prosthesis and neuroelectrodynamics. We are the Afrogenesis, where we are transforming challenges into possibilities.
Your thoughts are translated into commands that the robotic arm dutifully obeys.
Our aim in this structured scientific organization that we started 14 years ago, it is to come up with a bilateral prosthesis, bilateral structured machine unit that will aid with the mobility or help persons living with disabilities to move from being dependent persons to independent persons.
Thinking about grabbing that cup of coffee, the arm moves and does exactly that. Thinking about taking over the world? Well, it might need a few software upgrades for that.
My name is Moses Kiyuna Njoroge. As you all know, the content of your character is determined by choice. Day by day, what you choose, what you do, what you think is whom you become. 10 years of experience have helped me to be a self-taught innovator.
The arm itself? Let's just say it's not about the aesthetics.
Police, give way. Demonstrating the flow of the bio-robotic arm system under self-testing. Articulations levels, protocol sequences activated. Shoulder levels, X and Y axis, sequential testing initiated.
Check.
Elbow level, Y axis, sequential testing.
Check.
Wrist level, ulna at radius, Y axis, sequential testing. Rotate left.
Check.
Rotate right.
Check.
Made from scrap metals and salvaged parts, it looks more like a post-apocalyptic art installation than cutting-edge tech.
Initiating fingers, test sequence protocols.
Small finger, ring finger.
Check.
Middle finger.
Check.
Index finger.
Check.
Test sequence.
But don't be fooled by its appearance. This arm is serious business. It moves, grabs, and functions with a responsiveness that rivals some high-end robotics.
prosthetic arm system.
Sure, it rattles a bit like an old washing machine. But what's a little noise when you're bending the rules of technology? And then there's the functionality. This isn't just a gadget. It's a lifeline for those people with disabilities. Imagine losing a limb and thinking you'll never regain independence, only to be handed a helmet and a robotic arm that turns your thoughts into actions.
Wrist level ulna at radius Y.
That's not just innovation. That's hope wrapped in scrap metal.
This is an upper limb by robotic hand prosthetic that uses brain signals to locomote its hand, to move the hand according to your desires. This biorobotic hand uses those brain signals and converts those brain signals, amplifies them, filters them, then converts them into electronic current. And this electronic current is further pushed forward to the circuit of the robot, meaning it can convert user's thought into robotic arm movement.
But here's where things get tricky. As amazing as Afrogenesis is, it's built on a shoestring budget. You'd think the government or big tech companies would be throwing money at these inventors, right? These guys are essentially running on goodwill and pocket change, proving once again that brilliance often goes unnoticed unless it comes with a fancy logo.
We have already make up an AI device that you can speak to. We have nicknamed it Jeff.
Please wait until you see a color blue light, then say the word system to wake me up. Jeff is the password you are going to use to get into the system. Then after several beeps, I will respond to you through the following words.
Yes, Sema, Nakuskia.
Then ask what you want to be assisted with. Example, like turn on the lights, turn on TV, what is the time?
Nima Washa, CT Mach. I have turned the light on.
Ooh.
Watcha, Ufala.
Most of them, they weren't able to do the daily activities, like maybe going to switch on the lights.
You seem searching something. What are you looking for?
My other pieces you screwed out earlier.
Meanwhile, the tech world is busy hyping up yet another overpriced smartphone that doesn't even have a headphone jack.
Elbow level Y axis articulation.
System initiated.
And let's not forget the challenges. The helmet might read your thoughts, but it's not exactly user-friendly. Wearing it feels like strapping a spaceship to your head, minus the cool factor. It's bulky, awkward, and probably not winning any style points. Then there's the arm itself. Sure, it works, but precision, that's a work in progress.
They say they needed no classroom to hone their God-given talent.
Right now, it's like handling a toddler a pair of chopsticks. Impressive effort, questionable results.
Please give way, testing the flow of the biorobotic hand system under self-testing.
But despite its quirks, Afrogenesis is a game changer. It's a glimpse into what's possible when innovation meets determination. Forget the critics, the doubters, and the lack of funding. These inventors are proving that greatness doesn't need any glossy finish. It just needs a big idea and the guts to see it through.
The way you think, when we have a BCI gadget that you put in your head, so the way you think, it will act according to it. If you think to lift your hand, it will lift the hand. If you think to wave or to move the arm from left to right, it will do according to your desire.
Afrogenesis, the scrappy, ambitious invention that's redefining what's possible. It's not perfect. It's not polished, and it's definitely not quiet. But it's here, and it's making waves in a world that desperately needs fresh ideas. This isn't just a robotic arm. It's a symbol of what happens when creativity, resilience, and a dash of madness collide. Sure, it's got its flaws, but what invention doesn't?
System under self-testing. Testing the chest interface devices. 1. Phone call connections. Check.
So here's to the inventors, the dreamers, and the guys with the helmets that read your thoughts. The world may not know it yet, but this mindset building the future, one scrap at a time.